In 2011, the psychologist Daryl Ray scoured the evidence. Through an online survey, he interrogated over 14,000 people who had left their churches about their sex lives before and after religion.
We asked four questions. When did you start masturbating? When did you start having oral sex? When did you start petting? And when did you start having intercourse? And we compared those people who were raised most religious against those people who were raised least religious. And we had thousands of people in both of these groups. And what we found was there's almost no difference. Now, we did see a little bump in pornography. The older religious people got, the more they used pornography. And they actually exceed non-religious people by 5 or 10% in the use of pornography. Whether you're religious or not, biology happens. You're going to start masturbating, you start having sex. But what's the difference? Guilt. The religious people feel a lot of guilt about the premarital sex they're having or about the masturbation they started, and they don't know what to do with it.
So there's really no difference in the actual sexual behavior
right.
that religious and non-religious people indulge in.
Mm-hmm.
What is different is the guilt they feel
exactly.
or don't
right.
feel when they do
and
it.
And religions preach against pornography and preach against masturbation, preach against premarital sex, and it does no good. The highest use of pornography in the United States is in Utah and Mississippi. So these are things that churches preach against, and yet their members are using it even more than secular people do. When I give my talks on sex, I oftentimes ask, how many of you masturbate? And I'll get people raising their hands all over the place, maybe 80, 90%. Some people raise both hands. If I ask that same question in a religious group, nobody will raise their hand. But we know that somewhere in the neighborhood of 95% of males masturbate and 70 to 75% of females masturbate. So if nobody's raising their hand, that tells us they're lying. Religious people lie. My own grandmother lived 83 years. She went to the grave denying that she was ever divorced because her religious beliefs said divorced people are condemned and damned. So she never admitted it. We all knew she had, but that's the power of religion to hold an entire lifetime hostage. That's a lot of pain.